brothers and sisters, I want to tell you in this session, how can I change my life? Or let us put it the other way around. How can I change the direction of my life? You see, the reason why we are sucked by the world is some or the other, with all our religiosity, with all the sacraments, with mass, with novena, with rosary, even with retreat, some or the other, we are still on the wrong path. I want to tell you how to get onto the right path. Amen? You must make a U-turn. What must you do? Make a U-turn. Yeah? If you make a U-turn in your life, your life will never be the same. You know, once there was a prince. Yeah? Many of you may know the story. Once there was this prince, and you know, he threw a large party. He invited all the young people to this party. They were all excited. They put on their best wardrobe, and they came to the party waiting for the prince. Not very often anyone will get an invitation from a prince to visit his palace. And so they all came to the palace waiting for the prince, and surely the prince came. But before the party started, the prince made this announcement. The announcement he made is this. He told all the people, the young people and the not so young people also here. Yeah, a lot of not so young people are there. Maybe they missed a youth retreat in their days. Yeah. Well, you're most welcome. You're most welcome. So he made this announcement. The announcement he made is this. He told all the young people, he said this. Today, one day, you can go to anywhere in my palace, and whatever you touch will be yours. Whatever you touch will be yours. And the minute they heard the announcement of the prince, whatever you touch will be yours, all the young people just stood up. And they started running, helter, skelter in the palace, because the prince said, whatever you touch will be yours. And they were touching these beautiful lightings, amazing paintings, beautiful carpet, nice furniture. Everything in a palace is wonderful, precious, beautiful. They were running and touching everything. But there was a smart girl. This girl, the minute the prince said, whatever you touch will be yours, this girl stood up, walked to the prince, and she touched him. This girl understood something very important we need to understand at the retreat. This girl understood one thing. She understood that if she had the prince, she had everything. Amen? Say hallelujah. If you have the prince, you will have everything. For you and for me, the prince is Jesus Christ. If you touch his life, everything will fall in place in your life. Amen? Don't do the mistake that the people did in the palace, just running here, running there, running about career, getting a little healing, behind a girl, behind a boy, all your lives, yeah? How many people are running behind boys and girls? You want to see the true life? Go to the next retreat hall, couples. And you will see them sitting like this. Once I was at a couples retreat, I was preaching a couples retreat, and I told the couples, you know, hold the hand of your spouse. And this lady who's next to her husband, take. Juice has gone. Passion has gone. Romance has gone. Love has gone. Hold on. The key is Jesus. Never make that mistake. The key is Jesus. It's only Jesus who can bring life to you. No one else. Nothing else. Nobody else can bring life to you. Don't make that mistake. That's why I want to tell you, sisters and brothers, make sure at this retreat, pray hard that the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit, will touch you. And if you pray, He will touch your life. Because I remember many, many years ago, 44 years ago, I made a retreat like this and God touched me. Amen? Say hallelujah. Because I realized the giver is more important than the gifts. Yeah, if I have the giver, I have all the gifts. And that's what this girl understood. She touched the prince. She realized if she had the prince, she had everything. Don't run around. You will not get anything much. Nobody can fill the emptiness in your life, the loneliness in your life, depression, frustration. Only one person, Jesus Christ. If you open your life to him, you will live the fullness of life. You will experience the power of God in your life. There will be no dull moment in your life. Amen. Say hallelujah. Make this U-turn. Look what Jesus says. In the Gospel of Mark, chapter 1, verse 14 and 15. The time is fulfilled. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. Jesus, you see, Jesus started preaching at the age of 30. And what is the first message that Jesus preached? The first message Jesus preached is this: the time is fulfilled. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. Jesus came to his people and gave them the same message. All he told us is, repent, make a U-turn. Because if you don't make that U-turn in your life, you cannot enter into the kingdom of God. Why people have no peace? How many people come and tell me, brother, I made so many retreats. I have no peace. They make so many retreats that they are in pieces. Because they're not catching the right funda. They're only coming for retreats. Some people only come for retreats waiting for their name to be called. Some people tell me, brother, my name was called. I said, praise God. Show it by your life. Brother, I got a healing. Praise God. Let your life change. What is the point of your name getting called at a retreat? You getting healed and you go on the same path. No use. You have to make that U-turn. So Jesus is telling us the only way to enter into the kingdom of God, because the Bible says, you see, the kingdom of God is righteousness, peace, joy in the Holy Spirit. Romans chapter 14, verse 17. The kingdom of God is righteousness. When will you learn to live the right way, the correct way, the good way, the gospel way? When? When you enter into the kingdom of God. Righteousness is right living. Righteousness, peace. How many people have no peace after so many retreats? Because they have not made this U-turn. They have not made this U-turn. They have not entered into the kingdom of God. Unless you enter into the kingdom of God by making this U-turn, you will not experience peace. And you will not experience joy either. Right? No joy. Have you noticed some people how they live today? I'm talking about youth. No joy. Dead already. I saw this girl. She is 25 years old. 25. Walking like this. No idea where she's going. No drive in her life. No energy in her life. No purpose in her life. Already dead. If you ask her, honey, where are you going? She'll say, God only knows. Because she doesn't know why. Because God is not in control of our life. If Jesus is not in control of your life, you will be lifeless. You will be lifeless. How was your day? Okay. How many people said, how was your day? Okay. We don't even say it's good. No, okay. You see, okay is not a good answer. Jesus said, I come to give life in its abundance, the fullness of life. So when can you experience it? When you make the U-turn in your life. So what is this U-turn? What is this repentance? You see, the word repentance means change, turn around. It means to turn around 180 degree. Hello? Are you with me? If I'm going this way, in this direction, and at the retreat, you hear the voice of the Lord telling you, repent, change your life, make a U-turn. What will you do? You will turn like this, right? That is called 180 degree turn. You cannot keep going the same way in your life and expect a miracle in your life. You must make this U-turn. And when you make this U-turn, everything will fall in place, because now you are facing God. You are facing Jesus Christ. You have to make this U-turn. Many people don't make this 180 degree turn. I know people will come to a retreat and make 90 degree turn. 90? We call them cockeyed Christians. Look in Tokyo, see London. 90, no? Huh? Jesus is saying, true repentance is 180 degree turn. Some people come for retreat, you know, they're so emotional, everything is good for them, and you know, they go back home. And they, instead of making 180 degree turn, they make 360 degree. So in one month, they are back to square one. Why? You didn't know how to make the U-turn. You didn't touch the prince. You were running after the gifts. Jesus is so important. Touch him. Your life will never be the same. Then 180 degree turn will help you to do this change of direction. When you change your direction, it will lead to a change of heart and it will lead to a change of life. That is the power of repentance and changing your direction. This U-turn, you see, you make this U-turn and then surrender. We don't surrender and make the U-turn. No. We make the U-turn and surrender. Otherwise, you're still surrendering to the wrong person. Then your life will become different in your life. You know, in the Old Testament, there is Jonah. Have you heard of the prophet Jonah? Not your neighbor. Old Testament. Yeah. Amazing story. Let me paraphrase his story in a few minutes to you. You know, Jonah was a devout guy. A Jew. He knew the law. But now comes God calling Jonah for a special assignment. God tells Jonah, I want you to go to a place called Nineveh. Preach the gospel to them. Preach the word of God to them. They have done much harm. So that they will repent and come back to me. So that they will do this U-turn. Only one way to come back to God. Make the U-turn. Jonah said, I am not going. Why? Because Jonah was a Catholic. When God calls a Catholic, he says, not me. I am so young. My first retreat. I am 20. Why can't you take that uncle, 55 years old, only watching TV. Take him, unemployed fellow. When God calls the uncle, uncle say, Lord, why do you want me? My life is all over. Why can't you take that youth? Nobody is going, you see. All are saying, you go. I am okay. So Jonah said, I'm not going. The Bible says, Jonah, if God was calling Jonah to Nineveh, Jonah is going in this direction. He went to a place called Tarshish. He took a boat and he went in the opposite direction. God is calling in this direction. Jonah is going in this direction. Hey, when do you know you are committing a sin? When you go in the opposite direction to which God is calling you. You are showing your back to God. You are running away from God. That's why Jonah is known as the prophet who ran away from God. So he got in a boat and he went in the opposite direction to a place called Tarshish. And he was singing all the nice charismatic songs. Faith band was on the banks. And Jonah was, you know, opposite direction. Do you know what song Jonah was singing, going in the opposite direction? I surrender all. Oh, ho, ho. He's in the opposite direction. I surrender, Lord. I surrender everything. What everything? You're wrong path. I have decided to follow Jesus. Wrong path. What a mockery we make of songs. Important thing is to turn. So here is Jonah. Let me continue his story. Then the Lord thought, how to make Jonah make a U-turn? Because God also knows that Jonah, only when he makes a U-turn, the plan of God will be fulfilled in his life. You know what God did? Because he was going in the opposite direction, God brought a storm. Are you going through a crisis? How many young people are going through crisis today? Crisis after crisis. Crisis after crisis. You know why? You may be going in the wrong direction in your life. So God brought a storm. Told Jonah. The storm came. And God came with Jonah in that storm also. And God told Jonah, hey Jonah, if you repent, make this U-turn, 180 degree turn, go back to Nineveh. I will save you from this storm. Jonah told God, don't worry about me. I am okay. Save the people of Nineveh. So Jonah continued to go. The storm became more severe. Severe. Jonah is drowning in the sea now. And God comes. God tells Jonah, Jonah, I will save you from drowning. All you have to do is to make a U-turn, 180 degree turn, and get back to what my call to go back to Nineveh. I will save you from this storm. You're drowning. Jonah says, no problem. I was a swimming champion. National. Don't worry about me. You see, some of us are thick-skinned people, right? Whatever may happen, we don't care. Thick skin, too much of thick skin. I have a feeling, as I told you, Jonah must be a Catholic, not a Jew. Who are the people running away from God? All Catholics, all wrong track. I surrender all, don't know to who. I have a feeling, for most Catholics, Jonah is their patron saint.
And he continued to go in that direction.
We know the story. A big fish, a whale, swallowed Jonah. Imagine being in the belly of a fish 3 days, 3 nights. Whoa.
Imagine the belly of the fish. 3 days and 3 nights. That's why it is good for you to repent the first time. And now Jonah is in the belly of the fish 3 days and 3 nights, crying out to God, save me. You see, Jonah spent 3 days and 3 nights in the belly of the fish. In other words, Jonah made a closed retreat. And you know what happened when you make a good retreat?
Change will come. It is quite amazing what happened in the story of Jonah. This fish swallowed him. Jonah goes on his knees in the belly of the fish. He repents and says, God, I am so sorry for running away from you. So sorry for going in the wrong direction. I want to change. I want to repent. I am willing to make this U-turn. And the minute he said that, God came. The Bible says, the whale, the fish, changed its direction. And took Jonah to Nineveh and vomited Jonah on the shores of Nineveh.
When you go the Lord's way, you normally don't have to pay for your ticket. You got a free ride. Jonah, not you, be careful. Free ride. And the Bible says, Jonah repented and he preached one of the most powerful messages ever recorded in the Bible. When Jonah preached, the Bible says, the entire city of Nineveh repented. Wow. One man's conversion, one man's decision to turn around changed the entire city of Nineveh. You want your family to change? It will start with you. It will start with you. You want a spouse to change? It will start with you. It started with Jonah. The entire city of Nineveh changed. That's why it is so important to make this U-turn. The sooner, the better. And you're at a retreat. Look at the story of Mary Magdalene. You know, Mary Magdalene, she thought sex is the answer, right? Sex is the answer. And after some time, she realized that it cannot satisfy her. She lived a wayward life. She was a woman with loose morals. She lived her life like that until she met Jesus. And when she met Jesus, Mary Magdalene, she did this U-turn. What does it mean to make a U-turn? You leave your past life. Mary Magdalene became a disciple of Jesus Christ. Because only Jesus can satisfy our needs. No one else. Have you heard of Zacchaeus? You must read Luke chapter 19. You'll find Zacchaeus, short man, climbed a tree. Jesus was passing. He wanted to see who Jesus is, a very, very rich man. And Jesus looked at him, says the Bible. And Zacchaeus came running down. And then Zacchaeus got changed. His life turned completely. You know what Zacchaeus said in Luke 19? Salvation has come to my home. You see, brothers and sisters, when you make this U-turn, salvation will come to you and to your household.